To give the general idea of the magnitude of the conflicts during Three Kingdoms period, we will compare two biggest states of a time, Han and Roman empires. 90 years of continuous fighting that has spread all over the Han Empire resulted in catastrophic population decrease and economic decline. By the end of the 2nd century CE, Han Empire was administratively complex and ethnically diverse state. Its cultural and political life was dominated by ethnic majority of the Han people, who formed the core of its armies and bureaucracy. But the empire claimed also vast territories populated by other, smaller populations. Korean people in the east, Proto-Mongolian nomads in the north, mountain people in the west, and a number of non-Han tribal confederations in the south. Some of these people formed their own highly developed political entities, strong enough to resist the Han incursions, while others were subjugated, often falling under the influence of the Chinese culture or forced out of their land by Han settlers. The empire was a true powerhouse, divided into 13 provinces and a number of smaller commanderies, kingdoms, and dependent states. But despite its impressive size and apparent might, the empire was standing on the brink of a deep abyss. Severely ravaged by a corruption among its highest political officials, struck by natural disasters and famines, a weak government was unable to suppress numerous peasant rebellions such as Yellow Turbans and religious uprisings, Taoist celestial masters. To combat the rebels, emperor decided to give the provincial governors an authority to collect taxes and levy armed forces, and this crucial decision actually transformed the governors into semi-independent warlords who were competing for influence over the imperial court and ultimately leading to a collapse of the Han dynasty. Our story begins in 190 CE, when Dong Zhuo, a British military general, seized control over imperial court by capturing underage Emperor Xian and relocating the imperial capital to Chang'an. Dong Zhuo's efforts to secure power with iron fist resulted in a rebellion against him by a coalition of mighty governors. This war marked the beginning of the prolonged conflict between military generals, provincial governors, local clans, and indigenous tribes. The turbulent period of Chinese history that was about to begin is called the Three Kingdoms. Unification of China by Jin Dynasty in 280 marked the end of the Three Kingdoms era. However, the new dynasty didn't hold long, and shortly thereafter fell into succession crisis, civil war, and suffered from the invasions from the tribes known as Five Barbarians. But that is another story.